What's up, Dapper Squad? It's your boy Darius back at it again with JJK Season 2, Episode 3. This one is Hidden Inventory Part 3. Remember, if you guys want the full uncut, unedited version of this, check out that Patreon down below. You guys also get exclusive reactions, early access to the other shows, and you guys get to vote on what I react to next. Don't forget to subscribe, click that bell so you guys always know when I post over here on the Dapper channel. Not gonna waste any more time though. Let's hop right on into it. I am very excited. So they used Kuroi's phone to indicate to us that Kuroi had been kidnapped, which I am worried about. I actually really like her so far, and just her relationship with Riko. Even Geto feels somewhat bad. Yeah. As our main goal is Riko, you know? 100%. Yeah, and we know Riko is such a caring girl that she would love... Kuroi's all she has, you know? Okay. And you never get to see her again. Haven't said goodbye yet. Now, I get it, and I feel bad. Because it was like they were saying last episode. Yes, she has this destined assimilation goal with Tengen, but she still is a girl giving up her life at the end of the day, you know? Gojo's a little unempathetic right now, you know? I mean, he's very young, very immature, but it's glad to know that his empathy and sympathy are both gonna develop much later on, you know? But she's cool with it. She's cool with it. Alright, so no idea what was going on before the opening started. Thank you guys for letting me know that it was the Fushiguro was working with the religious group and not Kyu. I appreciate you guys. Is this a dream or did we already catch Kuroi and we're good? So either kill Riko if they can't do that stall to delay the assimilation time. The goat, his hair, I hate it so much, but he's the goat. Oh my god, I'm so glad he gets a different hairstyle later. He looks like Gaara from fucking Boruto right now. Hi, Bara. First year, do I know him? Hi, Bara. I mean, it's always nice to get your mind off things, you know? In his own way, which we like to see. A little bit longer. See, he's already getting more empathetic and caring about her. I like it. Besides what? So technically, it is safer. So it's very strenuous on Gojo, but he's taking this very seriously and is willing to sacrifice... He's willing to sacrifice his own bodily health for the sake of Riko, and I appreciate that. I take back what I said earlier. He has not sleeping, he's keeping his technique active all the time. I swear people in the comments told me this wasn't going to be a wholesome episode, or it was going to be darker than normal. Maybe I misinterpreted what they said, or maybe I'm misremembering, but this seems fucking incredible. Look at this. Lord, would I love to take some pictures here, enjoy this beautiful day. Great weather, great scenery, great nature, great food, great people. The Kuroshio Sea. Are we going to an aquarium? With the piano just hitting so marvelously in the background. I don't know whether to feel very happy because this is... hopefully one of the best days she's had in her life, or to feel very sad because it's one of the last best days she's ever going to have, you know? I feel like there's a lot of cinematic symbolism in that, like the exit sign flickering out, you know, protecting mission day 3. So this is where we like leave, right? Okay, we're officially at JJ at Jujutsu High now. He can finally turn his six eyes off. Wait. The literal millisecond he turned it off? And we are inside the barrier. All of Tengen's barriers. You are. You forgot your own son's name, but like, also, you guys told me that it's the voice actor for Zeke, Dio, and so many other people. I once went to see him. He saw a young Gojo. Never before or after had anyone noticed me. That's why he did all of this. The delayed Okinawa, knowing it would force him. And there are some variables in that plan, but thinking for sure that Gojo would go out of his way in order to keep his six eyes and not sleep and to keep everything active in order to physically drain him down to the moment there. I love how he said, since that moment, no one before or after has ever noticed me behind him. And it cuts right back. This is why I did it, so you wouldn't notice me behind. What the fuck? Immediate into the fight. We got some ghetto curse action. I mean, theoretically, it could be no damage done if what he's saying is accurate. Okay, fair enough. I will do what you say. I would love to see this. Mr. Fushiguro here is looking quite intimidating. Oh, I'm wondering the same things. Too many unknowns, damn it. He has zero cursed energy? Is he like a Maki? I love the way they're... Oh, that's, remember that shot from the trailer? I love the way they're animating it with the dark, heavy lines. He's not giving a fuck, though, how fast you are. Oh my god, he's just tanking all that. I need to know what that curse around his neck is. Does it just spit out weapons and eat weapons? Is that all it does, or does it have any added benefits onto that? Is he not there? He's even faster. Amplification, maximum output. Okay, fucking Pain, who are we feeling like? Blue sucks everything in like a black hole, right? He just cleared his surrounding areas entirely, so there's nothing to bounce off, nowhere to hide. He can see everything around him. There's no cover. He just made his own cover. Look at the amount of non-visibility there is. Bro, the battle strategy going on right now, I'm loving it. Yeah, he's after Rico. This all could be a time-delayed distraction. I didn't even see that. Oh my god, he's right there. That was so fucking sick. Oozing from this tool. It broke through? I was going into this fight so sure Gojo was gonna be okay because it's Gojo, and this might be the most brutal death I've ever seen on a character ever. Inverted Spear of Heaven? Forced release? I'm at a loss for words. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to feel. I can't even think about Riko and Kuroi right now. I'm just so thinking about what's going on at the surface. Crazy to think all this has happened, and in present day JJK season, we know nothing about this. We know the fucking son of the guy. What? Of the nation's key barriers? The main hall of tombs of the star? The names are so fucking crazy. To the base. What is this, like the Hagla tree? This is like Idrisil? He's leaving it up to you. This is so crazy how much I really fuck with this ghetto, you know? Really? They're willing to independently guarantee that, going against whatever, for their moral compass, you know? Right? That's how it be. And that's why I'm really fucking with Geto and Gojo right now, you know? They're going against their orders and missions to do this, but I did not think this arc was going to go down like this at all. I thought Rika was for sure going to get assimilated. How in the fuck are they just gonna start replaying the end? If this was still season one, early on in JJK, I would be pulling the shonen card. I would be saying, one, we know Gojo is gonna be okay. Two, there's no way. But I won't lie to you guys, and I have goosebumps all over my body saying this right now. Ever since the whole Junpei situation in season one, when they even showed him in the opening, I was for sure like, he's gonna be a main character, he's gonna be a fucking boy, he's gonna be our legend. And they killed him off, and we never see him again. That changed my perception on JJK forever. And now I'm almost convinced that, and it hurts way more than like if you're watching another shonen, because it's like Game of Thrones. It's like when you know that they're right after, like, literally the most cool, empathetic, most emotional, wholesome moment of this entire arc so far, and after I was just talking about how mad I was at Gojo earlier that we're not treating Rico better, and then he is treating Rico amazing, and then Geto's treating Rico amazing, and Kuroi is being amazing, and I was so happy. And for it to be Mr. fucking Fushiguro ex Zenin bitch ass himself, I won't lie though, in terms of intimidation, in terms of fucking violence, action, voice, everything about him is screaming fucking S tier villain right now. But it's but the fact that he made me this mad is also screaming that. I am livid right now. Oh my god, I liked her so much. See, and the thing was, I wrote down Haibara's name. Maybe we do know him in the future, but I was like, oh, a new guy who's young with Nanami. We know Shoko, we know Geto, we know Gojo. Maybe he's gonna be the one that dies. It's gonna be super sad. I'm gonna be butthurt. I don't even want to say hopefully. If you guys enjoyed this episode, please leave a like, because I know you did, but I didn't, but I did at the same time. I'm fucking pissed. I guess check out that Patreon if you guys want the full length. I don't even care anymore, whatever. I'm butthurt. Hopefully, I don't know. And then you guys said the Shibuya incident arc is supposed to get even crazier. Like, this arc is insane. All right, guys. Deuces. I'm butthurt. Peace out. Whatever. I'll-